see something completely different. Mounds of rubbish from the white plastic replaces the blue water. In Indonesia, despite strong growth in consumption, the waste treatment system is still undeveloped. So the river serves as an open rubbish bin, and the fishermen are now fishing bottles.
There are no more fish here because the water is too polluted. There are none left.
Rudy is 23 years old. He walks along the Shitaro for 9 hours every day. He works for a recycling cooperative.
But they are big.
I earn the most with plastic water bottles.
Hey.
I collect more than 50 kilos of them.
Under this mangrove forest, trapped in the roots, thousands of pieces of debris have accumulated, more each day. And a large amount is not collected. Indonesian rivers dump 200,000 tons of plastic into the sea each year. Plastic. Visible pollution. Shocking. But not the most dangerous. The Shitaro and its inhabitants suffer mainly from chemical pollution. To understand what's happening, we go to one of the many villages along the river and its textile factories. Nua has always lived here. Every morning, this 42-year-old woman goes to the well, which is fed by the Shitaro.
Do you know where I got on the hard side?
The colour changes. Sometimes it's black, sometimes it's red. This morning the water is clean, so I'm taking the opportunity to wash the vegetables. In any case, we have no choice. There are no other sources of water.
A doctor's appointment. The clinic is half an hour away by car. They do this twice a month. Yuna, her eldest son, falls ill as soon as he finishes his medication.
How long has he been sick?
For 3 days. Symptoms does he have? His chest hurts when he coughs. Yesterday he felt sick and he vomited as soon as he tried to eat. My neighbors have the same problems because we shower with the river water and the river is extremely dirty. Yes, we also see many cases of diarrhea, especially in children. It may be related to the contaminated water they drink. As for the skin diseases we see, it's hard to prove scientifically.
It's impossible to draw definitive conclusions. There is no epidemiological study, no proof of the impact of pollution of the Shitaro on local populations. For 17 years, he has been surveying the Shitaro in search of evidence of pollution by the textile industry.
What the hell? Danke, noch ein Gelow. Das nimmt der Hände.